Great weeb game.
Alright, guys. Welcome back to Dark Souls 1. Lore percent, which means it's going to take like 30 hours. So when last we left off, we went down into the depths and we picked up this fun fella.
Oh, hello there.
Mr. Laurentius.
As always.
Our pyromancer friend. Also, after killing Capra Demon, we activated Rhea of Thorland to come over here, and she went down to the catacombs with her best bud Petrus and her other friends.
Oh, you again? Me? I've become separated from my lady. I've scoured near and far, but no sight of her. Where could she have gone? My lady, to think I swore to protect you with my life.
Okay, so he's lying out his teeth right now. He knows exactly where Rhea is and what happened to her. They went on a journey down to the catacombs to find the Rite of Kindling. That's a girl, no. Where is... Yo, Krall, thanks so much for the follow. We're gonna spawn fucking, Lautrec back in. Thanks so much for the follow, Krall. Welcome to the stream. Hope you're enjoying the show. Here's Lautrec. Let's talk with him.
You certainly are keeping busy. Care to pay for a useful tip?
So, if we pay Lautrec some money, he's willing to give us some info. What do you know, Lautrec?
A wise choice indeed. Maiden Thuriland and her followers recently arrived in this land, but she became stranded deep below the catacombs. Her followers either fled or were reduced to hollows, leaving Maiden Thuriland all alone. Not a bad tip, huh? A Nubar cleric would be replete with humanity.
So that's really telling about what Lautrec himself is very, very interested in. Dre Love, thanks for the follow. Welcome to the stream. Hope you enjoy the show. And I really appreciate the follow. Anyway. That's very telling of Lautrec's own personality. His first thought when thinking about Rhea of Thuriland being trapped in the catacombs is not, oh, that poor girl, someone should save her. It's more like, if someone saved her, they'd be able to take a lot of humanity from her. Because he's kind of a douchebag.
That tip I gave you? I heard it from a fleeing old man. That poor bastard. All his robes and trinkets won't help him now.
Oh, why are we laughing, Lautrec? I mean... Okay.
You again. What is it? Our futures are...
Alright, we're done. Ay cha cha 230, welcome to the stream. Thanks so much for that follow. Glad to have you here, and I hope you enjoy the show. Anyway, he talked about a fleeing old man with robes and trinkets. Well, this guy looks kind of old.
Oh, hello there. Have you spoken with Sir Lautrec? Splendid.
Yup.
In the depths of the catacombs, Milady slipped off the giant's coffin and into a hole. Her two companions are no longer human. And the lass weeps in solitude. Right now, you could do as you please with her.
Little rapey.
The poor little purebred is entirely helpless.
It's a little rapey. So, the second you talk to Lautrec and the cat's out of the bag, I like how Petrus here, he doesn't even try to cover it up. He doesn't try to deny it at all and call Lautrec a liar. He's just like, nah, man. Rhea's in the catacombs. She's getting raped by skeletons. It feels good, man. Feels good, man. Because he's a douchebag.
Come again. The effectiveness of... In the depths of the...
Okay, that's it. So yeah, Petrus actually, the reason that he's doing this is because he hates nobles. He absolutely hates noble people. And Rhea of Thuriland is rich as hell. The only reason that she's off on this journey is because she's undead, and the undead in the human world are currently being cast out. They're being cast out of the human world like crazy, because people are scared of them. Played some Nep. Nice job.
Nice.
Glad you're having fun with that. Let's see. Yeah. I won't be able to do any of that, but we'll get this catalyst for the future.
What's that?
You got anything to say?
I'm not up.
Nope. Okay. She's not worth her salt. I mean, she could be. So now I kind of have, I have my choice of areas to go. My basic areas to go are either I go down to those scary, scary catacombs and try to help Rhea, or I go up to those scary, scary sewers and try to do sewer stuff. I guess we'll go to those scary, scary catacombs. Let's see, I think the Astora Straight Sword's the only thing I have that's truly good against the Skeletons. I can't use it at all. Nope, I don't have the faith yet. Man, my strength is low. My stats overall are low. Need more strength. I can two-hand the claymore. No hentai today? Nah, not today, Gulfin. Hentai is on Thursdays. So, despite this area being so close to Firelink Shrine, it's actually a very mid to late game area. And originally in Dark Souls 1, these skeletons wouldn't give you any souls at all. And that was kind of the hint of, hey, don't go this way. Don't go this way. Because these guys will fuck you up. And they don't give you souls. But a lot of people stubbornly just kept going this way and couldn't figure it out. On top of that, a lot of people checked out the new Londo ruins down below and got raped by ghosts. And then they said Dark Souls is impossible. And they gave up. So anyway, I'm using this big old claymore right now because of the fact that with the claymore, I can knock these skeletons down and keep them from kicking my ass. So I haven't been to the catacombs in a while. I'm going to probably get lost once or twice, and once or twice I mean like all the time. At least I haven't casually been here. These are floating heads that explode. Exploding floating heads. How nice. Come here, Mr. Skeleton. Come here, Jack Skellington. Get out of here. Get down there. Later, nerd. Use the Zwei? I can't use the Zweihander. I do not have the strength to even wield it two-handed. Otherwise, I could and I would. So, we're gonna run past these guys real quick. And this is a neat little trick you can do in Dark Souls. If you quit out, it'll de-aggro all those skeletons. And then you can kill the necromancer here to make sure that the skeletons don't reform. Man, I do like no damage right now. Get wrecked, nerd. Oh, he didn't drop the thing. Oh well. Did you get one of the DLC characters? Nice, Joggy. DLC character's pretty good. Are the skeletons coming back, though? The skeletons are coming back because of guys like this, necromancers. Necromancers have the ability to respawn the skeletons and re-raise them again and again and again. The only way to keep them from re-raising is to either kill the necromancer or to kill the skeletons with a holy weapon of some sort. Is why I was eyeing the Astora Straight Sword early on. It's a holy weapon. It fits the bill. Die. Okay. So before we move on, I just kind of want to look at a couple things. Had no idea they reformed until your second playthrough. You're going too fast, SoCal. So, something interesting is all of these statues, if you look very closely, have the Mask of the Father etched into them at the very top. This is kind of your hint at what Pinwheel is going to look like, and that's obviously the Mask of the Father. Anyone that's played Dark Souls knows the Mask of the Father of all Giants. On top of that, you got this door. I don't know what the emblem is supposed to mean. I kind of think that FromSoft art team just kind of Googled emblems and just kind of ripped a Google image off and threw it on there. But, you know. On top of that, some very interesting stuff with the catacombs that gives you some basic idea of how, like, the evolution of the world. If you look at the very bottom row here, all of these skulls are lined up all neatly in a row, perfectly on top of each other. And then the next row is kind of neat. It's a little bit messed up like that. And then even higher, all the skulls are just thrown, they're just willy-nilly. And that's because people were throwing their corpses down into the catacombs. And at first, they were kind of layering it properly. But as time went on, and as the undead problem became more and worse, and as they just kept throwing more corpses onto the pile, they just kind of started tossing them haphazardly. No more respect for the dead. And of course, when you push this in, the door is going to open on the other side. There's a hidden message and a texture from the DS3 DLC, really. Fancy. More masks of the father here. Interesting thing, if you run past these statues and some skeletons try to run through here, they get stabbed by spikes by the statues. So there's a necromancer over there. We're gonna go touch his butt. Were those bugs on the wall? Yeah. Eh. Butt touch. Those were bugs all over the wall. Okay, he's dead. Oh my god. Ow. Fuck me. Rough. This place is kind of rough. This place is kind of rough for the level I'm at least. I'm severely underleveled for this area. Anyway, here, I'll show off the, these bugs that are, like, slightly moving ever so tinily. They're kind of like, they look like they're pill beetles, in a way. They could also be something like scarabs. And, you'll notice them a lot in the catacombs. They tend to hang out around dying or dead things in Dark Souls 1, which is why they are down here. What level should you be for this area? Probably like 30-something, maybe 40, even. Was the Skull Lantern good for? It actually shows you some hidden pathways. And it lights up the area of the Tomb of the Giants, which is really helpful because it's dark. Freaking dark as hell. You know what? We're just gonna go with my scimitar. Oh, well, bye. The best description is they look delicious. I don't know about that. Oh no, there's another skeleton. So many skeleton warriors here. Okay, that pose that the skeleton's doing is a parry pose. If you attack him with a normal attack, when a skeleton is doing that pose, he will parry your ass off. Ow. That's a really fast attack. For Dark Souls 1. Look how little damage I do. I'm so weak. Been a while since I've been super weak in Dark Souls. Feels weird, man. Luckily, skeletons can't heal. Oh, see, that's the parry stance again. Hey, a falchion! Nice, let's take a look. Skeletons drop this. A small curved sword, each hit inflicts little damage, but fluid chain attacks are deadly. The falchion's sharp slashing attacks are effective against cloth and flesh, but bad against armor. This is actually one of the best fucking weapons against armor. Because you can do this. R1, 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 R1. And then you get yourself a big old stamina bar, and you two-hand and spam R1 with that, and it's really good. Look at that. Look at those spikes. I wonder what those are for. Glitch some levels? I'll do that later. Don't worry. Once we have a dupable soul, I will not feel bad about duping it. So you'll notice that the shield that the skeletons use here is the warrior's round shield. But they drop you the red and white round shield for some reason. It doesn't really make much sense. Ow. Ow. That's so fast, man. Come on, Mr. Skeleton. I need you to just let me hit you some more. Jumping attack! You can't parry that, nerd. There's no more necromancer in the area, so I can fight these guys and feel good about it. Two hand was bad idea. So all skeletons want to be a wheel skeleton more than anything else in the world. That's why they roll like that. Ow. But unfortunately, it also has an attack at the end of it. Eh. I really probably should have, like, grinded some levels before this. Oh well. Too late now. I've made my decision. Alright, dead. So this is like the true Dark Souls experience of get your ass kicked by the game because you're in a place you shouldn't be. This is one thing I really love about Dark Souls, though, is that you can just sequence break for no reason other than do you want a sequence break and just go here? Why not? So you'll see there's a lot more bugs around here, and they're kind of congregating around this big mound in the ceiling. And we'll see what that is on the next floor soon enough. There's actually kind of a reason for that. Ta-da! Aha! Okay, nothing. How do you duplicate and cheat levels? If you have a soul that has a yes or no prompt, you can use it infinitely if you time things right and know what you're doing. I love when the skeletons jump over and break themselves like crazy. It's nice. So, skeletons are originally not supposed to have souls because they're reanimated by Nito. They technically don't actually have a soul in them at all. They don't have the Nito soul in them, the soul of death. I see you naughty, naughty skeletons. They don't have the soul of light, they don't have the dark soul or the soul of life. They're soulless. They're just bones. But, because of complaints by players saying that the game was too hard and that it was unfair for them to not give souls, FromSoft kind of toned it down just a little bit and said, hey, here you go, they'll drop souls now. Hello. How are you doing, Mr. Skelebones? Yeah, do the blender. Got him. So let's get the Lucerne. I'm actually going to make some special note about the Lucerne. The Lucy. Everybody loves the Lucy. Because the Lucy is a pretty unique weapon. So, we'll take a look at it. We don't have Aurora Alk here to tell me when I'm wrong about history, but historically, the Lucerne would be used as a spear, and you'll see that FromSoft doesn't know how to use weapons properly because this is terrible. This moveset is absolutely awful. So the point of it is a spear. It was used as a spear historically because spears are the best weapon historically because they have a long reach. The beak on the front of it, despite what FromSoft may tell you with animations like that, the beak was actually not really used to plunge into armor or anything like that. It was used more to hook onto to riding cavalry and rip them off their horses. And at the same time, if it's a little bit sharpened, then it might do a little bit of damage too, but mostly it's to get assholes off their horses because horse riders are douches. And the hammerhead on the other side of it would actually be used a lot more as a weapon. Specifically, it's designed for fucking up plate mail. Because in history, when plate mail was introduced, it was very, very difficult to actually get your weapon to get good effects on the plate mail. You had to really drive a weapon in there or get in between the slits of where the plate mail is put together. So they came up with this genius plan of let's get a big, thick hammer piece on certain weapons, and then we just smack into their armor and we break their bones. And it's a really visceral way for combat to happen. The hits reverberate inside of the plate mail and it rips muscle ligaments apart. It crashes bones. It's really, really brutal. So it's a really cool weapon, like historically. I hope you guys enjoyed history time. Why do some players use the Black Knight Halberd? It's a very good weapon. It's a very strong weapon. All Black Knight weapons in Dark Souls 1 are really strong. And all of them are super worth using. What the fuck am I tinking against? The invisible wall, apparently. What the hell am I hitting? Eh, whatever. Spears are the best group fighting weapon. The halberds are incorrect too. Yeah, links are allowed, no problem. Oh, also, before we continue, I did want to point out one thing that I absolutely hate about some of FromSoft's move design. Attacks like this. This R2, look at this R2. This R2 is the worst thing you could possibly do in combat. Because this is back in the time of medieval times where there's like fencing and there's very fast spear thrusts and stuff like that. If you turn your back even for a second, you are dead. If anyone's ever seen like professional fencing in today's day and age, it is insanely fast. It's incredibly fast. And that back turn right there would kill you 100%. So once again, this might come back to that point I made before of the Chosen Undead maybe is just kind of an idiot and never got any proper weapon training for the majority of weapons that are available in Dark Souls. The only things he tends to use properly are stuff like the S-stock and basic thrusting weapons. Then again, it's hard to get thrusting wrong. Alright, we got the archer over there and his friend right here. Tell us more about history. Historically, skeletons didn't do this. You want to get out of that corner, buddy? Are you trapped? Oh, did he find his way out? There we go. What a big man. What a strong man you are. What a big, strong man. I'm so proud of you. And you're dead. Oh, you went back. All right, see you, nerd. I'll need to talk to you. Is this PC? Yes, this is on PC. Oh, here's the item. Boop. Large soul of a nameless soldier. You see that, this is a proper crypt. The catacombs are a very proper crypt. Like, they've got slots for dead people to be laid in. Or at least deeper into the catacombs, you get to a proper crypt. But on the outside of it, you can tell they were just kind of piling bodies up. But when you get further in, you see the slots for the undead, for the dead guys to be in. A slot for a window to go where they've bricked it up over time. And candles properly lit. And one really cool thing about the candles is you'll notice that it's not always the same candle design. Like you see there's a little goblet there. There's one candle lit and a few that aren't. If we go to, well, that's the same and that's the same. Hold on, there's different ones. Yeah, like that. This one has two candles lit instead of just one. See, I told you, they're different here and there. So someone went in and, like, carefully placed those. The physical damage resistance on this is the Grass Crest Shield, so it is 95%. There's nothing here but that skeleton that was hiding. I just wanted to double check. Because I forget a great deal of the catacombs, casually. But I do remember what this is. Spikes. More spikes. More spikes. Nope, no spikes. Exploding heads. Oh, there's the other one. Fuck. Alright, there we go. That's what I wanted. I wanted to just get that one off the cliff before this one showed up. Get out of here, nerd! No, no, no! Ugh. Okay. Let's just take our binoculars out instead of healing. Hey guys, I want to look at the camera real quick. I hope you don't mind. Boink. Okay. Oof. No spikes. So, one thing you may have noticed, you're paying close attention over there. No, that's not the thing, okay. So you'll notice levers like that around the area. Oh god. Where did this one come from? I'm actually curious. Where the hell did you come from, Mr. Skellabones? Okay. So there are levers like this all around the area. Well, if you look over there and pay close attention, it causes the bridge to turn. Nice. Would Dark Souls be like if it was first person? It would be difficult. Oh! It's the Necromancer bringing you back. Shoot, I should have been paying more attention. That's right, there's a Necromancer in this area. Oh, please. Bounced off the fucking wall. Okay. Gonna have to be a little bit quick here. Go through this one. Through this one. Or not. Am I gonna be able to do this properly? So yeah, if you you can pull the lever out and reflip the bridge if you want to. Like this. Hi, Mr. Necromancer. I see you're on that bridge. Oh, poor fella. You don't use it because it's not 100% resistance? Aw, but the grass crest shield's so good. Alright, now the Necromancer is deed. Deed forever. Dropped into hell. Oh. Really? Huh. No range, man. Alright, one of you, get aggroed. Bunk. So fire is pretty decent here. Pretty decent. Oh, he tried to parry. He tried hard to parry. I wonder if these spikes will get them too. Let's see. Nope, no spikes for them. Stop blocking, assholes. Can't catch me. It's practically the best shield in the game. It is the best shield in the game. Best shield in the game by a lot. Nice blender. You are dead now. Forever. We get souls. Yeah, the easiest way to tell whether or not an undead, a skeleton is dead is if you get souls. Alright, this is the way down to Vamos. I wonder if I can make it. Why do Dark Souls bosses look so nasty it makes you sick? Alright, this is the trap. Dark Souls bosses don't look too nasty. Happy New Year from New Zealand, as it is officially 2017. Happy New Year, Cyber Tiger. Thanks for wishing me Happy New Year. So that is a nice little trap, but it also brings you to these crystal lizards. Whoops. Twinkling Titanite and a white Titanite chunk, and if ever you miss some crystal lizards, you can always just reload the area, and they will spawn back in. Bam, green Titanite from that one. Ow. And thus, we make it to the top of the ladder. But wait, there's nowhere to go. Luckily for us, more holes. And this brings us right back out to where we were before, and we looped all the way around, back to this. If this jerk... Oh, these jerks. Not this jerk. Oh, no, no. Go ahead and put your parry stance back up, friend. Oh, what a dodge. What a god. Eh. Where'd the other one come from? He shouldn't have been here. Killed you after the necromancer was dead, man. Go away. Nobody likes you. Nobody likes your kind. You're just a filthy skeleton. Go ahead and heal. Luckily, humanity lets us heal. Hey look, explodey guys. And more skeletons. Okay. Skeletons got back up again. Okay, so yeah, that was that. The only way forward is to go down. Hello, skeleton. Get backstab, nerd! So the catacombs are really deep. Really deep. Like super deep. They're also deep. They're also dark. They're deep and dark. Ooh, give me that. So if you get too close to that when you pick it up, you get stabbed by stuff. Owie. So, more skeletons. Oh shit, right. Necromancer, where is he? Where is he? Where is he? Where is he? This is the wrong place to be. This is the bad place. This is a bad, bad place. The scary place. Full of scary people. I'm dead. Rip. I got wrecked. Oh, these skeletons are really annoying. Let's do this. Oh god, I need a lot of points in faith. Let's get one in strength then. This way at least I can get the claymore and use that instead, because it'll be much better against the skeletons than what I got. Do 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 do. The skeleton's gonna parry the world someday. So you notice you can kinda do a drop off that area if you want to. And it is a shortcut in a way. We're gonna have a lot of skeletons following us at this rate. Whoops, wrong way. Gonna be a whole lot of bone warriors coming our way. Hello, skeletons. How are you doing? Nice blender. Oh no, he just did the roll. What a jerk. Let's just do this way then. There he is. Alright, I'm gonna get rid of the skeletons real quick. Wouldn't the Morning Star be best? Nah. The Morning Star is good because it breaks them, but it doesn't knock them down, which is what I'm looking for. Ow. Man, that's fast fire, dude. Come on now. Stop it. I'm trapped in the wall. Trapped between a douche and a douchebag. Alright, we're good. Eh. You know what? Maybe we'll do the Morning Star. I'm not a fan of the Morning Star. Never have been. But it is good against the skeletons. Alright, we got him. We got him. Now let's push this lever. I wonder what it'll do. Maybe it'll open something up. Damn it, drop your head, idiot. Okay, so we've got our choice of places to go. We can, double checking. We can go down there. As you can see, there is a body to light your way. Or we can go to where that, where this opened. You can see there's an item right over there, too. I like how Dark Souls shows you items just out of reach so that you know they exist, and you just have to find them. What the fuck just happened? The Great Scythe. Yes, Socala Aviator. I know. I know. AKA greatest weapon in the game. I mean, it's good. It's better than it should be. So what the hell was that? I don't understand why they just went through my shield. Ow. Well, we haven't gotten to the next bonfire quite yet. Not yet. Too busy getting murdered by skeletons. Get wrecked, skeleton. Oh, nothing different over there, nothing different. Oh, look, there's a doorway now. That's what we opened up. For anyone wondering. Go ahead and grab this while we're here. Soul of the Proud Knight. Spikes. Go away, skeletons. There's a lot of skeletons down here, guys. There's, like, an unfairly large number of skeletons that like to hang out in the catacombs. But it makes sense. Let's see, I just want to, do this. Okay, good. You can't follow me. Okay, you can try. You can sort of succeed. And with that, we get the Great Scythe. That's what that door opened up to us. So, let's go ahead and take a quick look at the Great Scythe. It has good dex scaling, strength scaling. It's actually a pretty good weapon, too. Weapon with a long curved blade converted from a wheat harvesting tool. The magnificent sharp curved blade instills fear in opponents. Perhaps it is their survival instincts at work. Yes, perhaps it's their survival instincts. So, the thing is that traditionally in history, yes, scythes were used as weapons. But if they were used as weapons, it was very common they were not used like this. Because this is terrible. Instead, what they would do is they would break off the end of it, reorient it, and then tie it back on tightly and use it as a spear. Because a spear is an actual weapon and a scythe is a corn harvesting tool. Or wheat harvesting. Or whatever you want to harvest. Harvesting tool. Oh no, we fell! In case you're wondering, yes, there are more of those. More of those falls. So, you know what? Let's walk around with the scythe for a little while. Why not? Oh god, they know I'm here. Can you blow up, please? Thank you. The scythe is very good against the skeletons, because it always breaks them. Always breaks them. And the R2 does very high damage to them. Skeletons are weak versus scythe. Oh no, they're not dying. Where's the, there's another necromancer, guys. You can always tell if they're gonna die if you get the souls or not. If you don't get the souls, there's necromancer around the corner somewhere. Shoot. Yeah. Scythe OP. Scythe's pretty good. Alright, this is this area. Shoot. Wish I was on the other side. Yo, Delta Fenrir is here. Welcome, Delta Fenrir, to the channel. Glad to have you here. Hope you are enjoying the show. Thanks so much for the follow. I greatly appreciate it. And welcome again. Thanks so much for the support. Crap, I forget what where the next necromancer is. Eh. Well, I guess you'll hurry me along. There's the archer up there. It's best to move fast in areas like this when you're surrounded by enemies. Let's get the tomb. Dark Moon Seance Ring. Alright, this is a really important ring. We're going to read about it really soon, but there's a giant skeleton and like four other skeletons trying to kill me. Let's get the fuck out of the dodge! Move, 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 run! Okay, we're good. Phew! Okay, not good. Not good. Toxicities is now following. Welcome to the stream, Toxicities. Very glad to have you here. Hope you're enjoying the show right now. Welcome to I Forget What the Catacombs Is Like. There's a necromancer. Let's get rid of these guys. Thank you so much for the follow. I really appreciate it. Thanks for helping the channel grow. Again, never be scared to just quit yourself out and fuck over the AI this way. Ow, not good. I'm dead. I'm not dead. PogChamp. I'm alive. Like a god. But the necromancer in the area is still alive too, so that's unfortunate. Let's see. Now I have to remember where the hell I have to go to get to places and things. Obviously not this way, because this is going backwards. Right? Yeah, this is backwards. Also, I need to get rid of this. I need to read the Dark Moon Seance Ring description for you guys. In a moment, or two, or three, or seven. This way is the wrong way, right? Yeah, because the bridge is not done. I probably should have played through this area before doing the stream stuff. Oh well. You guys get to see live, raw footage of Thor being an idiot. Not like it's never happened before. Do-do-do-do-do. Don't think I missed anything when I was back here, did I? Fuck off, skeleton. You're too far away from the necromancer now. You can't do nothing. Oh yeah, I missed this. I missed this. This is actually an important place, so we're gonna kill the skeleton and get rid of him. And he's gonna revive. Nice, awesome. No, don't revive. I scattered your buff. Skeleton. Okay, instead we're gonna get rid of this skeleton temporarily. And I'm going to read that Dark Moon Seance Ring before we continue through the catacombs here. Okay. So the Dark Moon Seance Ring grants an additional attunement slot. This ring is granted to adherents of Gwyndolin, the Dark Moon deity and lastborn of Gwyn, the Lord of Sunlight. Grants an additional magic attunement slot. The Dark Sun Gwyndolin is the only remaining deity in Anor Londo. His followers are few, but their tasks are of vital importance. This ring is super fucking important in the game, lore-wise. This is your first hint that Gwyndolin exists in the first place, if you didn't go kill Guinevere. It's your hint that things in Anor Londo aren't all as they seem, because it says Gwyndolin's the only deity left in Anor Londo, which means that Guinevere is a fake. And it shows that A lot of what you see in Anorlando is not real. And you find that in a tomb down in this place, which is kind of interesting that you would find the Dark Moon Seance Ring in the tomb, but it's possible that that was a Dark Moon adherent that was dead there and had the ring on him at the time. So, we gotta get past this Titanite demon to do the other thing. We're gonna go say hi to the boss. So if we just nestle in this coffin, as only the chosen undead would, and we just hang here for a little while. Hey guys, how you doing? You guys enjoy sitting in coffins like this? I do. It's peaceful in here. It's comfy. I like it. I think the rest of the stream will be this coffin. Comfy coffin. So, nothing happens. However, if Foist can come over here and grab this, and you have at least one Eye of Death on you, don't do it. And then you get all comfy in the coffin. Yeah, he'll leave you alone if you're in the coffin. If you get all comfy in the coffin while you have at least one Eye of Death on you, then you just sit in the coffin again. It's just a really comfortable coffin, guys. I like this coffin. This is the rest of the stream. It's comfy coffin stream. Sir? Excuse me? He doesn't know I'm here. What an idiot. So you wait long enough in the coffin with an Eye of Death. Skeletor, yeah! Well, that was like the most comfortable nap I ever had. Where the hell am I? So, prepare for the boss of the Tomb of the Giants. The Tomb of the Giants is the area right after the catacombs. Let's go check out the boss. Behold! Pray to the sarcophagus gravelord. This is Nito, boss of the Tomb of the Giants, and one of the holders of the Four Lord Souls. He holds the soul of death, and he has a bunch of arms and legs just kind of dangling out of his chest, because he's a dead guy that's made out of a lot of other dead guys. So, if we pray, we can enter a covenant with him. This is the Gravelord Covenant. And we get the Gravelord Sword and the Gravelord Sword Dance Miracle. So the Gravelord takes Eye of Deaths to level up the Covenant. Let's take a look at the Gravelord Sword real quick. It looks funky as all hell. I don't have the strength to wield it. Whoops. It's 24 strength. So, a sword wielded only by servants of Gravelord Nito, the first of the dead, crafted from the bones of the fallen. The miasma of death exuded from the sword, a veritable toxin to any living being. So this is the Gravelord Sword. It's actually a pretty decent sword. It's not bad. It does good damage, and the R2 does this. But when you can't wield it, you can't do the one-handed stuff. But at least I can two-hand it. The backstep on this is actually one of the better backsteps in the game, because one of the biggest problems with backstepping in the game is the fact that you don't get carried forward far enough with your next attack to hit enemies, but with this one, you do. The other problem is you don't get any iframes when you backstep. So in addition to that, we got a miracle. Our first miracle, the Gravelord Sword Dance. It's pretty neato. Miracle known only by the servants of the first dead, Gravelord Nito. Giant Gravelord swords jut out in the vicinity. Nito sleeps deep within the giant catacombs, quietly overseeing all death and waiting for his servants to usher in the Eye of Death. So, Nito is a really cool character design, but they don't really do anything lore-wise with him. They kind of have a cool cinematic opening where he lifts his hands up and goes, "I'm helping!" And then that's about it. So they gave him this covenant, but Nito never really talks or anything like that. And you have to get relatively established in the covenant for more lore on Nito. We'll do that later, as we need a lot of Eyes of Death. Eye of Death is a PvP item, by the way. The main way you get it is through killing other players as a Gravelord sword. So let's get back in the coffin. I like the coffin. And of course, if you get back in the coffin, eventually Skeletor will come back. And he'll take you back up to the catacombs. So I think that's kind of cool that one of the bosses of the game is a Covenant leader, and you can meet with one of the late game bosses of the game pretty early in the game, actually. You can come down to the catacombs at level 1 if you want. And back we are. Oh god, he's over there. Why is he over there? You know what? No. Get out of my face. I can just trek my way back there. Fuck that. He's gonna kill me anyway. This ain't Souls 3? I know, Emily Nunn. It's much better. I guess we'll go more strength. We'll keep it quality. Quality build. Quality build. So if anyone can't tell, I have every intention of going to murder Pinwheel. Every intention. Excuse me, pardon me. I gotta go this way. Let's see. Over there, maybe. Title and game aren't apparently changed yet. Why? Why title? Why Twitch? Come on, man. I changed the title. It's changed on my dashboard, but that means a whole lot. Basically. That means so much. Have I been here? Yeah, I've been on this side before. Yup, I've been here. Darn. This isn't what I was looking for. Is this the right way or the wrong way? What about the bug explanation? What's there to explain? There's bugs, yo. At least I'm aware of it now. Yeah, thanks. Here, let me just double check here. And update information. There we go. Okay. Alright, skeleton. God, the scythe is so strong against the skeletons. It does so much damage. Let's carefully not fuck this up. I fucked it up. I done fucked it up. Damn it. Pile of flesh on the higher floor on the roof. Oh, right, that thing. Right, yeah, I know what you're talking about. Just hug the wall and jog. I always did it by rolling, I just rolled in the wrong area. Oh god, please. I'm dead. Wait, I'm not dead! There we go. I'm dead. I just rolled a little bit too far to the left. I hate when hitboxes of totally breakable things get in your way like that. It's kind of dumb. Oh well. Why are you not holding shield up, man? I have button pressed. You're talking about this over here, right? Ow. I might have remembered that incorrectly, but I'm almost positive that is an area you can fall down into from above. Here, blow stuff up, man. No, not me. Blow them up. That freaking attack, man. Like I said, there's a lot of stuff about the catacombs that I might misremember or be entirely wrong about. Get wrecked. Please, get wrecked. Stay wrecked. Forever. Jesus, these skeletons. They drive me to drink. Oh, nope, I've been down here. All aboard the I Am Lost train. Choo-choo, choo-choo. Many choo-choos. This is nothing. There's more down here. More skeletons. Even more skeletons. Alright, this is that. Just remember to revisit Lautrec after you save Rhea. Yep, that's the plan. That's the plan, that's kind of why I'm trying to get her. I saw that swing, mister. No, don't knock me off. You get off. You get off. Get out of here, filthy skeleton. There we go. That's how you do that. Green Titanite Shard. I don't remember if you can land on that thing over there. But we can make this drop if I'm at full health. I guarantee. And we're good. And we drop one more. Into a cutscene. So this guy is not talked about often.
Be gone with you. You spoil my focus.
He also has a really creepy voice modulator on him. Oh my god, are you kidding me? Really? Skeleton? Fuck you. Fucking skeletons. So this is Vamos. He is another blacksmith. And unlike Andre, he seems to have an idea of how blacksmithing works, because he has some molten lava here to superheat the metal so that it will become malleable. Wow!
Hmm? Why, you have an ember, do you? Forget about it. I don't deal with that kind. What has gone wrong with embers these days?
So, this guy can modify your equipment. I don't have anything available for Ascension, but he can give you some, I believe he does Chaos Modification and Fire Modification for your equipment. Also, of course, he can reinforce. Speaking of which, reinforce this scythe a little bit, shall we? And if you go to sales, he sells homeward bones, obviously. Titanite shards, as he is also a blacksmith. The armorsmith box, and your standard arrows. Go ahead and bump that scythe to +2. Nice. Let's go ahead and talk to him.
I'm here to smith, not to chit-chat.
He doesn't like talking.
I've told you, I'm here for the trade, not for the talk.
Oh, come on, man. You gotta have something you want to talk about.
Enough with your presence. It disturbs me.
Come on, buddy.
Well, you are a persistent one, are you not? But I'm afraid I'm a mere blacksmith. It's just me and my trade. I would be of no help to a righteous warrior such as yourself.
A righteous warrior? Come on, man. Talk with me.
You are a persistent
And that's everything, I guess. Alright.
If that'll be all, then be gone with you. You'll spoil my focus.
So clearly he is here for blacksmithing and blacksmithing only. He really gives a strong meaning to the term big boned, because he has some big bones. Wow. Very large bone gentleman. It's actually kind of weird. It looks like he has some shoulder pads on. Some sort of armor shoulder pads on. Other than that, he has just got very large bones. And on top of that is his face has a beard made of bones. Which is fucking weird. He has a beard made of bones. I don't know why his beard is made of bones, but it is. I guess they really wanted to give this guy a beard, and they couldn't do it because he was a skeleton, so they're like, just throw some bones in there, it's fine. Some lore backstory about this guy. If you kill him and you take his, you'll get a hammer and a royal crown or something similar to that. I forget exactly what it is, but it suggests that Vamos was, in his lifetime, royalty of some sort. And at one point in time, he would have been probably a prince at the very least. But now he is just a simple blacksmith sitting down here in the catacombs with all the other skeletons. All the other skeletons. That's how you get to Vamos, and he opens up a shortcut to hell. He opens a shortcut to hell. Welcome to hell, guys. We're gonna probably die. Do it. Don't do it yet. Okay, this is the pit of the bone wheel skeletons. Oh shit. Fuck you. So this is the most dangerous set of normal enemies in Dark Souls 1 are bone wheel skeletons. These things will rip you apart in a matter of seconds, even if you are very high level. But the fact that I am very low level is a little bit concerning, and I'm gonna have to be smart. There's a Black Knight sitting up there. Hello, Mr. Black Knight, and there's some souls here that will explode on us. Let's get him. No, I was trying to be sneaky. Okay, we can one-shot him now, thank God. That Black Knight will jump down. Wow, his bone wheel went flying. Here he comes, here comes the Black Knight. There's more, oh God, they're patrolling. Shoot. Shit. Don't do it, Mr. Black Knight. There's bone wheels in this area, oh God. Dude, Air Jordan over there. Get out of my way. Hey, this Black Knight has an axe. He has the Black Knight Great Axe. Whew. Which is a very, very heavy and strong weapon. And it broke my guard in one swing. Damn. It broke my guard in one swing. That is rough. I didn't really have much intention of fighting the Black Knight. The Black Knight's kind of strong. By the way, if anyone can give me directions to that other, whoops. to the other bridge that I haven't been to, because I cannot for the life of me remember how to get to that goddamn thing. Gonna get the blacksmith killed? Nah. Never. I've never gotten an NPC killed by accident. Not once. Never in my life. Thank you for all the lore. Have a happy new year. All right, Commander Christoph, here we go. This is what I was looking for. Thank God. All right. All I had to do was do that little drop. And now we have the other one. There we go. Is this the one with the illusory wall near it? This is not the one with the illusory wall near it. Damn. Oh, well. Still, this is, going the way I wanted it to. Oh, wait, it is. It is, I'm dumb. There's the illusory wall, it's just down. See, I told you, I forget about the catacombs a lot, and here is the second bonfire of the catacombs. Everybody? So you can rest at this if you want to. I'm kinda gonna go for it right now. Getting out of the catacombs is going to be annoying, but otherwise, there we go. That is a hidden bonfire in the catacombs. God damn it. Nice roll. Hey, what's this way? What's in here? Oh, right. This is this area. Okay. I don't need to go this way. I've been that way. Now let's go this way. Hooray. Don't you drop down here like that. I saw it. I have eyeballs. You gotta like how you do that running step forward by default for the R2 on the scythe. Because your character really means it when he swings it. God damn. Yeah. So skeletons in Dark Souls 1 are a lot scarier than the ones in Dark Souls 3 that you may have seen before. The Tomb of the Dark Moon there. Oh, they're getting back up. Right, the necromancer in the area. That's nearby. Look at all these skeleton warriors. Come here, head. Oh, wow. Red Tear Stone Ring! What a setup! What a god! Let's do that thing where I'm lost again. Okay. You're just gonna come back, aren't you? Yeah, you're gonna come back. Let's leave. Let's leave. Yeah, this is just to the Titanite Demon. So I don't need to go this way. As I've said before, there's no shame in quitting out when you're in a bad spot. Especially if you're like me and you're taking on areas you shouldn't be anywhere near. Let's see, where's the... Isn't there a drop-off around here that you can do? Yeah. There it is. Boink. This'll get us the large soul of a nameless soldier and get us one step closer to Bone Wheel Pit. Let's just walk off gently. There we go. And this is the preset. Full-on preset. So let's go ahead and take a quick peek at that. Holy trousers! Robe donned by men of the cloth. Though plain to the eye, its hardy fabric repels rain and keeps the body warm. Those dissatisfied with church teachings must test their faith by going on a spiritual journey, such as the spiritual self-purification of the Way of the White. along with traveling gloves, holy trousers, and a priest's hat. Distinctive hat worn only by way of the white priests in Thurland. Simply meant to show their position within the hierarchy. It holds almost no meaning in the land of Lordran. It's basically useless in Lordran. And we also get a proper mace. And when I say a proper mace, I mean a proper mace. Look at that. That is a mace right there. It's a big iron hammer with protrusive pommel. Standard weapon for clerics. Simple bladeless strike weapon is effective against most foes and can break the guard of a shield. However, one miss leaves one wide open. So, traditionally a weapon like a mace would be used against heavily armored enemies. Once again, this is the same principle where you want to hit with a very thick, heavy, hard blow onto them and break their bones. If you can't pierce their armor, you break them from the inside out. The reason that the mace has those little divots in it, and it's not like just one hard round ball, is that because of basic physics, that actually transfers the kinetic energy a lot better when you have the kind of pointed edges like that. And it makes for harder, more visceral blows. Okay, where'd the bone wheel skeletons go? They're right here. Hey guys, look at me. I'm over here. Get the fuck out of here. Go that way. Damn, look at him go- look how long he goes. Oh, hold on. Let's see, I got the perfect thing for this. Hold on. Wait, where'd he go? Where'd he go? Oh, come on! I had it perfect! Come here, other guy. Yeah, there you go. You jump into this for a little bit. There we go. Go, Bone Wheel Skeleton, go! You'll win that race! A little bit of Night of Fire fits really well for the Bone Wheel Skeleton, forever spinning. His wheels will spin forever. Alright. Let's get the fuck out of here. Let's go to the boss as fast as possible and hopefully not get followed. We're not being followed, PogChamp. Alright, let's go die to Pinwheel. I haven't died to Pinwheel in such a long time, it'll feel amazing. So there's some water down here. Shows that this cave has a little bit of moisture in it. Either that or it's ceremonial for whatever the hell he's doing. I'm touching skeletons. So one thing you'll notice about Pinwheel is made out of an actual family. Ugh. Fire! I don't think you can backstab Pinwheel. Just don't recall if you can. No! Let me kill the fakes. Oh, that's the real one. Okay. So, Pinwheel can be a little bit dangerous if you mess up and get hit by a magic. However, he's also rather easy to actually dodge. And the duplicates that he spawns aren't always the most convincing, considering they do nothing. Eh. Okay, that's his fastest attack and probably the most dangerous one to watch out for. Where is he? There he is. So now he's summoning the Pinwheel Gang. And they will now start shooting fake magic to confuse you. And he can teleport and change position with them. But the real one always has a tell. And that is the little black magic that goes around him. Hey, we didn't even get hit by him, thank God. So, by the rite of kindling, you can now make bonfires awesome. Let's take a quick peek at the rite of kindling. It is a rite which boosts bonfires even further. This secret rite allows bonfires to be bolstered further with kindling so that even more Estus can be collected. Kindling was a sacred rite passed down among clerics, but all undead can imitate the process, in the same manner that they restore their hallowing with humanity. How peculiar that humans had found little use for humanity until they turned undead. So with this, it makes us able to kindle better. So that kind of begs the question, damn it, Mask of the Child. That kind of begs the question, why is the church after the rite of kindling so badly? Why did the church send out a search party to try and find this rite of kindling? Well, one of the reasons could be that if you pay close attention, you'll notice that the Way of the White adheres to the wishes of the gods, obviously. The wishes of Gwyn and the other gods. And the wishes of the gods is for the Age of Fire to continue. Kindling the bonfires is technically strengthening little pieces of the first flame to make sure that the first flame itself can't go out as long as the bonfires exist. Because the bonfires are little fragments of the first flame. That's why when you die, you can respawn back at them, because your soul is a fragment of the first flame itself as well. Every soul is a fragment of the first flame. But for some reason, for one reason or another, only the undead and those with the dark soul can be respawned by the bonfires. And humanity strengthens it. So the gods are trying to use the Dark Soul, the thing they fear the most, to stave off the Age of Dark. And that's kind of why they keep sending members of the Way of the White, members of the church, down into the catacombs to try and find the Rite of Kindling. Now, what Pinwheel was doing with it is questionable. It's kind of hard to say. Maybe he got it from Nito. Maybe he stole it from Nito, because Pinwheel is, after all, supposed to be three people, three family members, a mother, a father, and a child, all kind of crammed together by some unholy ritual that Nito might have done. And they may be, like, look at all these books. They were doing some sort of ceremony. They might be trying to research a way to undo that. They've got a lot of dead bodies here. I think the dead bodies are just there for ambiance. So we got the Mask of the Child. Let's take a quick peek. One of the three masks of the Pinwheel, the necromancer who stole the power of the Gravelord and reigns over the catacombs. This mask belonging to the naive child slightly raises stamina recovery speed. So it raises stamina recovery. It actually does, it does stack with the Grass Crest Shield. You see, my stamina recovers insanely fast now. It also looks creepy. So it flat out tells you Pinwheel stole some sort of power from Nito. And that power is probably the Rite of Kindling. Always had a little theory about the cycles. We know there's a cycle of chosen of people having to kindle, but what if when you do not kindle the flame, the entire thing restarts? For example, you don't kindle the flame in 3, it goes out entirely. Well, that's kind of what actually does happen. If you do not kindle the flame goes out. And then the Age of Dark comes. Shortcut ahead. Well, that's a dev message. I can surely believe it just fine. It's so dark in here. Well, I might as well just walk right off. I forget exactly where this leads. I kind of wish I had a skeleton lantern. Of a Proud Knight. Oh, yeah, it just leads right there. It does let us get the soul of a Proud Knight. What if that's a second cycle I'm already in? an item up there, too. I can't remember how to get up there. We'll do that later. Does the grass crest shield and the stamina ring stack in DS3? I think so. I'm not 100% sure about DS3, but I think so, yeah. It should. So this is the Tomb of the Giants. We shouldn't be here. This is a scary, deathly place. I'm going to use all of my memory of speedrun strats, and we're just going to run straight to a bonfire real quick. And then we're going to go talk with Patches. Nice hard fall, video game. 10 out of 10. It gave us a hard land, a